Hello and welcome back to iSpy. This video will cover the cover test. And in cover test, we'll look first at what is cover test, then little bit background information about trophia and phoria, and then procedure that how to perform cover test. So the cover test is an objective method to determine the presence of strabismus and also to differentiate between heterotropia and heterophoria. Now, before proceeding into cover test in detail, here is a brief introduction to heterotropia and heterophoria and their types. So, heterotropia is misalignment of the eyes, that is manifesting, where manifesting means something which is very obvious to the eyes, that if someone has heterotropia, it will be clearly visible to everyone. For example, in this picture, you can see that left eye is deviated, which is very evident as compared to the right eye. And heterophoria is also misalignment of eyes, but it is latent in nature, that it is not manifesting, means that it is not clearly visible. For example, you can see this picture that both the eyes of baby looking normal, but there can be phoria present and something is hiding it, and that something is fusion. Still, the fusion is there and squint is not manifesting itself. And this is also the principle of cover test, breaking the fusion. Let me explain. I guess you all know the grades of binocular single vision, which is simultaneous perception, fusion and stereopsis. And in cover test, what we do is stopping the simultaneous perception by covering the one eye. And if there will be no simultaneous perception, then there will be no fusion and no stereopsis. And in absence of fusion, the squint which was hiding will become manifest. Now, the type of heterotropia and heterophoria on the basis of direction of misalignment, and that may be horizontal, vertical and rotatory. So horizontal deviation can be inward, that is towards nose, or outward, that is towards temple. So when eye deviates inward is called eso, and when deviates outward called exo. And tropia and phoria is added as suffix depending on the type of squint observed. For example, eso can be esotropia when squint is manifesting, and esophoria when squint is latent or hidden. Same with exo, also it can be exotropia and exophoria. Now, vertical deviation can also be of two types, that upward deviation and downward deviation. Upward deviation is known as hyper and downward deviation known as hypo. And it can also be hypertropia or hyperphoria, and hypotropia and hypophoria. Now, the rotatory movement or deviation is also of two types. That is, eye can rotate inward, that is towards nose, or can rotate outward, that is towards temple. When eye rotate inward is known as incyclo, and rotation outward known as excyclo, that can be incyclotropia or incyclophoria, and excyclotropia and excyclophoria. So this was a brief introduction of squint from my side. Rest you'll have to study in detail. Now move on to the types of cover test. So cover test is basically of two types. One is cover and cover test, which is also known as unilateral cover test, and other type is alternate cover test. So cover and cover test is used to detect the presence of manifest squint or heterotropia. And now some of you will think and say that if heterotropia is already visible, then what's the need to detect? So let me tell you about the term called pseudostrabismus, in which patient seems to have squint but actually there is no squint. An example of those conditions in pseudo exotropia are wide IPD, hypertelorism and positive angle kappa. In pseudo-esotropia are prominent epicanthal fold, broad nose bridge, short IPD and negative angle kappa. So to rule out if the actual squint or heterotropia is present or not, cover test is used. An alternate cover test is used to detect the presence of heterophoria and it is performed after cover and cover test. We'll see procedure of both one by one, but before that I'll tell you about the target which should be used and some point to note before the procedure. First, the important points about cover test and its procedure. First is that the cover test is binocular test, so patients both the eyes should be open during whole procedure. Second is cover test should be done with or without prescription both, so that the effect of any refractive error on deviation can be determined, but usually it is done with prescription only. During cover test, room illumination should be appropriate so that examiner can observe the any deviation easily and target will also be clear for patient if room illumination will be good. And cover test is performed at distance and near both the distances. But if there is any patient using intermediate distance for reading or close work, then perform near cover test at that distance which is patient's habitual working distance. Now, next is about the target used in cover test. So, for the distance cover test, target should be a single letter to avoid unnecessary movement of eyes. Size of the letter should be one line larger than the visual acuity of the poorer eye. For example, if patient's right eye's visual acuity is 6.9 and left eye's visual acuity is 6.12, then target letter size will be 6.18, which is one line larger than the left eye's visual acuity, which was poorer eye. Now, for the near cover test, target should be a single letter of a size one line larger than the patient's near visual acuity of the poorer eye, same as for distance. Or a fixation stick should be used that contains letters or pictures of various sizes. Now, finally, the procedure for cover test. Examiner sits directly in front of the patient at a distance of 33 to 40 cm away, but examiner should be very careful not to block the patient's view of the fixation target. Then explain the test to the patient and instruct the patient to look at the target and keep target clear all the time during the procedure in distance and near both. Now, perform the cover and cover test to look for heterotropia. Take an opaque occluder. Ask the patient to fixate on a distant target for measuring deviation at distance and at a near target for measuring deviation at near. Now cover one eye of a patient. But the question is which eye should be covered. So cover the normal looking eye if already squint is visible. Else cover either eye for few seconds and observe for any movement in the uncovered eye. For example, you covered the left eye. So observe right eye which is uncovered and look for any movement. And as you can see, right eye makes a movement that indicates right eye has strabismus. After 2 to 3 seconds, uncover and cover the left eye again and repeat this for 2 to 3 times and interpret the result as per observation. That is, if the right eye moves outward to take a fixation on covering left eye, so right esotropia is present. If the right eye moves inward on covering the left eye, so right exotropia is present. Upward movement indicates right hypotropia. downward movement indicates right hypertropia. And this was about when right eye makes any movement. What if on covering left eye, right eye doesn't make any movement? That indicates that there is no strabismus in right eye, and that's the time to switch the cover from left eye to right eye. Now cover the right eye and observe left eye and repeat it for 2 to 3 times. Then record the result as per observation that if the left eye moves outward on covering right eye, then it is left esotropia. Inward movement is left exotropia. Upward movement is left hypotropia. And downward movement is left hypertropia. And if on covering right eye, left eye doesn't make any movement, then there is no strabismus present in left eye. And if on covering right eye, left eye makes movement, and on covering left eye, right eye makes movement, both the eyes makes movement alternately, on covering the fellow eye indicates alternate strabismus. Repeat the whole cover and cover test at near distance, then move on to the alternate cover test. Alternate cover test. In alternate cover test, place the occluder before the eye, before the any eye for 2 to 3 seconds and transfer it quickly to the other eye. And again keep the occluder for 2 to 3 seconds and shift to the other eye and repeat this cycle. Just make sure that patient doesn't see the target binocularly at any moment. For example, cover the left eye. Keep the occluder for 2 to 3 seconds. Then shift the occluder and cover the right eye along horizontal line and keep the occluder for 2 to 3 seconds and observe the eye which is under cover on uncovering. So in alternate cover test, you need to observe the eye which was under cover on uncovering and note the result as per observation that if the eye under cover makes movement outward on covering, then it is esophoria. Inward movement is exophoria. Upward movement is hypophoria. Downward movement is hyperphoria. And if there is no movement, it is called as orthophoria. Repeat the test at near distance too. Now, I'll tell you how to record the result, whatever you observed. First, write cover test or CT in a capital letter to mention cover test. Mention if patient has wearing any prescription. Then record whatever you found during test. For example, for ortho or no movement, mention NMD in a capital letters which states no movement detected. Then mention which eye is deviated as capital letter R for right eye, capital letter L for left eye. And for alternating, mention ALT. Then add direction in which deviation was observed as ESO, exo, hyper, hypo, incyclo or excyclo, where eso also written as capital letters SO and exo also abbreviated as capital letters XO. And at last add suffix capital letter T for tropia and capital letter P for phoria. And of course, mention the distance of the test at the end, at which test was performed. Let's see this example, which states that no movement detected during test. Viewing wearing appropriate refraction. So this is how you can record the result, whatever you observed in the cover test. And I hope this video will help you.
Thank you for watching. Like, share, comment, and subscribe.